Hey there, peeps. Bunny back here with Final Fantasy XII, the Zodiac Age. I'm gonna apologize in advance. I am not feeling well. And on top of that, I am trying to change my sleeping schedule. So, honestly, I don't feel awful tired right now because I just woke up, but I don't feel good either. So, I'm gonna try to remember to speak up. Not slur my words, and try to have a little bit of enthusiasm about playing. Just be mindful that you've got a limited amount of time for your ride. Alright, well, I guess we'll just make it as far as we can, as fast as we can. We won't really go out of our way here. Oh yeah, we got sprint and dismount. I'm gonna think this way. So it's kind of in the eastern. Sorry. All over the place. It's a cute little chocobo jingle. Thinking left.
This one was a success.
Wow, I'm impressed, Bon.
I got a good feeling.
An alliance between Delmasca and the Empire.
Reason tells me 'tis the only course. We must avoid a wasting war with the Empire at all cost. Yet I fear I could not bear the shame, had I but the strength.
A shame, perhaps, for me and for you. But for Delmasca, it is hope.
And you can just accept this, can you?
After Vayne's ruse, I had abandoned hope for honor. Yet, never did I forget my knightly vows. If I could protect but one person from war's horror, then I would bear any shame. I would bear it proudly. I could not defend my home. What is shame to me?
My people hate the Empire. They will not accept this.
There is hope.
Right?
Don't encourage
hope for a future where we can join hands as brothers.
Larson, please. This is serious.
I'm sorry.
Don't be Larson. Somebody's gotta put him in his place.
The Senate may play at intrigue, but Lord Vayne is not one to be brought down easily. The entire military waits upon his orders, from the War Council down to the rank and file. What better blade than he to strike down the enemies of the Empire?
Your honor reminds me of Zett 2 years since. He, too, put his trust in Lord Vayne's strength, and what became of him? Gone without a trace since Nabudis.
I will not hear you malign Judge Sect. He was a noble warrior. Or do you think his trust in Lord Vayne ill-placed?
Vayne took two of his own brothers' lives. He is ruthless beyond contempt.
Ruthless, you say? Would he were more so. He gives traitors no quarter, be they of his own blood. How fitting for one who would bear the burden of Empire.
But could we bear him? Zagabath, what of you? Surely you do not believe his brothers were traitors?
so found His Excellency Lord Grammys, you would do well to mind your tongue, Drace. That matter is long past.
Your Honours, a summons. Lord Vane has arrived at the palace.
We come at once.
Lord Larsa has left for Boromyces. He hopes to enlist the aid of the Grand Kiltius in stopping the insurgents. I doubt this will be enough to deter Ondor, but even a slight hindrance to his operations would be welcome. This will delay the Rosarian invasion, and we will have bought much-needed time to shore up our defenses.
Just as His Excellency had hoped.
No matter the result, I'm pleased with the young lord's progress. I can already see the stunned faces of those mud-witted senators. The fools think a child emperor's strings easy to pull from the shadows. But they will find that Lord Larsa is no puppet.
Yes, the senators would be most pleased with a puppet for an emperor. Recall, Drace, how the Senate fears and despises Lord Vane's ability? When they realize the truth, that Lord Larsa is no docile lamb to be shepherded, they will bare their teeth and devour him.
You are right. I shall speak on this matter with His Excellency at once. Gabranth, it falls to us to protect Lord Larsa. Are we agreed?
Aye.
So it seems there's basically a rift there. Some that side with Larsa, some with Vane. And that maybe Larsa's not, maybe also bad as his brother. Alright, let's see here. We got a crystal there. I guess let's dismount. I mean, we made it this far. Alright. Wow. Alright. Save it here. If you haven't seen the previous very short video on me getting the sight and grot, I do have that. It's equipped right now on Fran. We'll see, because then if I need to, I can bring her in. Or when I do bring her in, it'll just should cut right through most of them. Huh. Okay. So is that then going to be where we're headed? Is wherever he had that barrier blocking him off? Golmor Jungle. Keep trucking along here. And it's gonna be wow, big place. Like there's the little Marlboro guys, and then the others are, and there's the Mulva Dooms, or if these are just all you see of Marlboros. So we got Slow and Sleep. Okay. Paul Thier, why are you always the one getting put to sleep there? Do I have something? Look like it. I was gonna say, do I have something that takes, what am I trying to say? Sleep off slow? I can deal with, I guess. So I can deal with better than sleep. Did I grab that? Yeah, I grabbed whatever was in there. I am not completely focused. Alright. Let's try to get with it here. We'll just plow through these guys. I have no idea what I'm doing. There we go. A lot of status effects in this area, it seems. Whoa, shit! Okay, hang on. Yeah, that's not okay. What are those, hellhounds? Yeah, that was unexpected, because I wasn't, like, status effects aside, I wasn't really having a lot of issues there, but let's get both the air back in there. Yeah, that. Quite unexpected. Okay, so here's the stairs. So, yeah. A barrier. Bring her back in. Yeah. and then keep on trucking here. Like this way, right? And we'll just go check out this little bit of area up here. That bow's saving my butt right now. Good enough. So, swing left down here. The heck are you? Huh. So it looks like there's gonna be some way to take these barriers down. I just don't know what we're gonna have to do.
What is it?
Maybe we find out here.
The jungle denies us our passage.
What have we done?
We? No. I.
What's that mean? How are we supposed to get through that?
Making an appearance?
Come on, I'm talking over here.
I thought you'd left for good.
Hey!
Our choices are few.
Friend? Balthier!
This is as much for you as it is me.
Oh?
You are ill at ease. The Nethersite troubles you. You've let your eyes betray your heart.
Right.
Huh. There's an interesting story with these two, I'm sure.
Soon you will learn.
Whoa.
That's pretty cool.
We go to seek aid of the Viera who dwell ahead.
I bet they'll be glad to see you after so long.
I am unwelcome, an unsought guest in their wood. In the village ahead, you will find her, Mjern. Bring her to me. She will know why you call her.
There, sorry about that. Peter's doing things on me. Very curious about the story. Let's see where this goes. You guys just follow me around or something? Looking for... I thought you looked... Oh yeah, that's the guy from, yeah, Leviathan. Well, yeah, I did, actually. I don't have a lot of money. I might have some loot. let's get rid of them. Get rid of the loot. Magicites. Huh, anyway. I mean, they're not worth a lot, so... can't be worth keeping, right? Still not enough to buy most stuff. I hate dealing with trying to buy, like... the armors. Let's see. Immune to sleep. I think I need to get that for both the ear. Immune to disable and immobilize. Might not be bad to have one of those on hand for one of the mages. Same with that, but I'm gonna... I'll just do a little bit at a time. Alright, let's see what we got going on. Mjern. It's kind of an interesting name. Wow. Erui Village? Is that Erui? Not sure how you say that. I've got some confusing names in this. They really are all over the place with their naming. Unwelcome in the woods. She will not suffer humans to walk her verdant paths. Her barriers deny you. Leave now whilst you may. They don't like us. I have a feeling I'm gonna get that from a lot of these guys. Thinking this way. And not a lot of point in talking to a lot of these guys. They're just gonna tell me they hate me and I don't belong here and I don't get it. A lot of cutscenes in this, so apologize for the lack of commentary.
Hey, Mjern lives here, doesn't she? We're here to see her.
You will leave at once. It is not allowed for humans to walk on these grounds.
We'll go as soon as we've seen Mjern.
If you can find her.
We're not leaving until you let us see her. Fine then. We'll look for her ourselves.
Ah.
I've heard the voice of the wood. She says Mjern is not in the village. Jote, where has she gone?
Why do you ask? The wood tells us where she has gone. Or can you not hear her? You cannot. Your ears are dull from hearing their harsh speech, I think. Viera, who have abandoned the wood, are Viera no longer. Mjörn, too, has left her embrace.
And you forsake them in turn?
It is the will of the village. Viera must live always with the wood. So is the green word, and so is our law.
We'll let you worry about keeping your laws. Just do us a favor and stay out of our way. We'll find her ourselves.
Wow. Ballsy.
Your sister has left the wood and gone west. She wanders warrens among men who hide themselves in clothes of cold iron. Thus to me has the wood spoken.
Huh?
The Viera may begin as part of the wood, but the wood is not the only end we may choose.
The same words I heard 50 years ago.
Viera is to abide by the green word. It is only natural that Jote's will and the will of the village be as one. If the green word forbids contact with the world outside, then so must it be. Well, I guess we're going west to find this Mjörn. Trying to find words.
Not bad, Vaughn. Didn't think we'd get any information out of that one. So then, what was she saying about men in a warren?
The Henemagicite mines. Maybe that's what she meant. They lie in Bangkor, south of the Osmoan Plain. The entire region is a colony of the Arcadian Empire. There would be soldiers.
Is that a problem? Let's move.
Fran.
Yes?
I was wondering what Jote said, you know? About how you said the same thing 50 years ago?
Oh, no.
Your point?
Don't do it.
How old were you again?
Ah, God. Wow. Awkward.
Nice fun.
Oh, surprisingly rude.
Try to grow up, please.
Does make you wonder, though. I haven't heard anything on age with Viera. How long they live or anything. Go back to Osmoan Plain in the west. The Hen Mines are then only a short distance south. Sounds good to me. Been a lot of cutscenes in this one, so yeah, they really do, like, you start off with Rex, with the tutorial stuff, and then move to Vaughn, And it seems like it's going to center a lot around him, and it kind of does, and like, I guess it focuses on him trying to be, let's see here. Thing. Right. To a certain extent, I mean, you have... sort of this focus on him doing his thing in a way, but at the same time... there really seems to be this focus on little details with Fran and Balthier. That intrigued me the most because, like, it just has that mystery factor a little bit. Like, we kind of, we get Bosch to a certain extent at this point, and know he has a twin brother. But, like, we're given a little bit more details about everybody. Like, in Ash, we know kind of what her gist is. She's... I guess I'm a sucker for those mystery characters that they give you just enough to make you wonder, but they leave you hanging just enough to make you want a little bit more. Is that our chocobo, though? No? Oh, hey, who are you? We fled here from the Hen Mines. We were attacked. It's all we could do to make it this far. Rest here until my friend's wounds have had a chance to heal. If you like, we could lend you the use of a chocobo until then. There's a lot of terrain around here which can't be accessed without a chocobo. You let me know when you need one. Cool. So do we need a chocobo to get where we're going? Or is that just like, hey, take your option if you want to bypass all that stuff? Oh yeah, look. Okay, so that one, yeah, there's no path. I bet we need it. Borrow one. Sure sign that a path is nearby is the presence of chocobo footprints. Well, that's exactly where we're going, buddy. How come we can only stay on him for, like, a limited period? Where's the fun in that? They don't like you exploring too much, do they? What the hell is over here? You can take care of yourself. Like, if he's attacking, like, a poor little Moogle or something. But, it's a hunter. Okay. Well, I thought we were gonna have to go that way, but maybe not? Hold on. I don't even know what he's talking about with chocobo footprints. Oh, apparently I was. I thought maybe that since that was cut off down there, that certainly that's where we were supposed to be going, but I don't see any indication. As to that being the case. So, I mean, I'm nearly out of time here. Yeah. We do have handy dandy Fran with her bow. So I'm gonna go kind of check this out. See, I don't know what it means by chokeable footprints. I don't know how obvious that is. To get to the Hidden Mines, we're gonna have to take a path that's chocobo only. Is what it sounded like, but maybe this is where we're going. Get to the chopper. Is that what that was? Which would sound like a weapon to me. Yeah. It's a dagger. Dagger's 3 license. So where are we now? The Zertnin Caverns. So yeah, no, that's not where we're going. Right? No way. It said south of the Osmo Plain, but not through the caverns. Ruh-roh. Seems like Sarah might be lost. Here. I might see, that way I'm just not putting you through this, and I don't have to also edit like 20 minutes, 30 minutes of me looking around out either. So yeah, I'm gonna end the recording here, and then I'll just come back when I find out where I'm supposed to go. I might look around a little bit more, and then see if I can figure it out. If not, I'll just probably have to look it up, but like I say, I won't make you sit here and just watch this. So, I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for tuning in. Hit the like button if you enjoyed yourself, and subscribe if you haven't done so. See you guys next time.